I wrote down 22 things that I wanted in my future wife if that was to ever happen. And I did that 5-6 years ago. And babe, you have literally surpassed that. You've doubled it. The word love in the dictionary needs to have your face next to it. You are everything I've dreamed for and more. And if this is going to be our 1-year anniversary, I can just imagine our 5, 10, 25, 50 year anniversary. God really took his time with you, I believe. He sketched, went back, drew it again, used a ruler or whatever, but he designed you perfectly for me. And I believe he designed me for you. And I thank him for it. I thank you for being a part of my crazy world. We're crazy together, and I love every minute of it. And it's 365 days in a year, and it hasn't been one day since I first met you that I've not thought of a reason why I love you. And I can come up with every reason that I'm in love with you, and every day I'm more and more in love with you, and we just grow from here. I appreciate you, what you've done for our children, my family, inviting me into your family accepting me, but you just accepting me. Where we met was perfect timing, and that only shows how good God is. And God really shows me how good he is, because he provided you. And I thank him, and I thank you, and I love you, and let's just continue to grow. I am always your wild berry turnip, inside joke, but I love you, babe. Thank you, and let's continue this journey.
and Solandra have invited us here today to share in the celebration of their marriage and a continuation of their commitment. We are here together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to recognize a bond that already exists. Chaz and Solandra, you have shared the joys, blessings, and challenges of married life for 1 year.
Man, that's a miracle.
And that's good. Are you going to make it, man?
She cheated.
For 1 year and today. You joined with family and friends to reaffirm your union. We're here in a grateful appreciation for what has gone before and in loving anticipation of the years ahead. I want to say this about this couple. I've seen them the last year, and they're just awesome people. Chaz is an awesome man. You're an awesome woman of God. And this past year, they have really impressed the leadership of our church with the way they've carried themselves this first year of their marriage. And I told my son, I said, if you want to know what I want you to be like your first year of marriage, I said, you look at Chaz Davis. This is a man of God. This is a man of God. I'm proud of this man of God. And I want to insert that before we kept on with the ceremony. Man, you've done well. You've done well. Today, Chaz and Solandra are celebrating what has already begun and will continue to grow for years to come. They have chosen symbolic vows to share with you all as they reestablish their vows they made 1 year ago. We will then share our vows. Okay. Do we have any rings? We got some rings. We got rings. Okay, we got rings. All right.
Kleenex.
Wedding rings are an outward and a visible sign of an inward spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and this woman in marriage. This circle of metal is an emblem of the sincerity and the permanence of a couple's love and regard for one another and their union. As the precious metal turns again upon itself, so does a marriage turn upon itself for its refreshment and renewal. Take your rings and exchange them in the spirit of love. Repeat after me.
Give me a second. All right.
Ready? I'm ready. Okay. With this ring.
I wed you.
For today.
For tomorrow.
And for all the tomorrows to come.
And for all the tomorrows to come.
Please wear it. As a sign.
To all the world.
That I've chosen you.
To be my one and only.
My one and only.
Wife.
Okay, Solana, repeat after me. With this ring.
I wed you.
For today.
For tomorrow.
And for all the tomorrows.
And for all the tomorrows.
To come.
Please wear it.
As a sign.
To all the world.
That I have chosen you.
And you only.
To be my husband.
Again.
These rings don't symbolize shackles or control. She stands by your side, you stand by his side, and you guys are side by side. There's no control in marriage. It's teamwork, it's partnership. And Solandra, I can say this to you. You're with the man who's gonna keep you safe, protect you, pray over your family, and provide for you. And I think any father would want that kind of man to be with his daughter. And that man is Chaz. And Chaz, I can say to you about Solandra. She's a woman of God. She's a woman of prayer. She's a faithful woman. You take those gifts and you allow those gifts to make you a better man. Amen?
Mm-hmm.
Glory to God. At this time, we're going to have the reading of the sand ceremony.
Groom and bride, may your love always be constant as the never-ending waves flowing endlessly from the depths of the sea. Just as the waters touch and nourish the many shores of the earth, may your love be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Just as there will never be a morning without the ocean's flow, there will never be a day without your love for each other. Today, this relationship is symbolized through the pouring of these two individual containers of sand, one representing you, Chaz, and all that you are, or the, all that you were, and all that you are, and all that you will ever be. The other representing you, Shalandra, and all that you were, all that you are, and all that you will ever be. Each one holds its own unique beauty, strength, and character. They can stand on their own, be whole, without the need of anything else. When the two are blended together, they represent an entirely new and extraordinary love relationship. Each grain of sand brings the mixture a lasting beauty that forever enriches the combination. As these two containers of sand are poured into the third container, the individual containers of sand no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage be forever in a day. Please pour the sand into this common container to symbolize the union of two lives. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into another into the individual vases, so will the love and bond between the two of you render
you have more than me.
Inseparable.
Face me. As we join here today, let us surround Chaz and Shalandra with our love and best wishes for them throughout their journey together as husband and wife. Father God, we thank you right now for this day. We thank you right now for this time. We thank you for the miraculous power of God that's taking place here. Father, we thank you for heaven's endorsement over this couple. And Father, we thank you right now that the goodness of God will reign and rule in their lives. Heavenly Father, we thank you right now that the hand of God will be on their lives from this day forward. Father, we thank you that the favor of God invade their lives. Heaven's limitless supply continue to manifest itself in their lives, in their future, in their children. And Father, we thank you right now that this day is special. Father, we thank you that this day is holy. This hour is holy. And Father, we thank you right now that these two have all the anointing, all the grace, and all the character to continue to move the will of God forward in their marriage. We give you all the honor. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. And that's in Jesus' name, and the church said amen.
Amen.
Through this renewal of their commitment on this day, they are declaring to each other and to the gathering of their families and their friends that they will be by each other's side no matter what life brings their way. It is my pleasure to once again present to you Mr. and Mrs. Davis. You may turn and face the congregation.
Hey babe, I just want to tell you how much I love you and I appreciate you, and thank you for everything you've done to get us to this moment. You've been awesome, and I just want you to remember this when times get hard. Just think of this moment, babe. Love you.
Always and forever, each moment with you is just like a dream to me that somehow came true. And I know tomorrow will still be the same, 'cause we've got a life of love that won't ever change. And every day, love me your own special way. Melt all my heart away with a smile. Just the things that you do. And if you get lonely, and take a second to give to me that magic you make. And every day, love me your own special way. Melt all my heart away with a smile.
The thing that's coming up for me to say is don't put your mouth on what God has already put his hand on. And I say that even for myself, for this relationship, I didn't know how much this man was going to bless me. He didn't look like the man that I thought I was going to be with. But he's more, a lot more than what I could have expected. And I thank God for him. I thank God for the children who also, they bless me so much. And I just thank you all for coming.
Found somebody yet? He said, I think I have. I said, I ain't seen him. I said, I know you serious when you bring him to see us. He brought him to see me and my wife. And Chaz is a person. I'm glad that he called me Pops, because we're not physical blood, but our spiritual makeup is the same. He's a wild boy, but he's a good man. I'm gonna say it again. You're a wild boy, but you're a good man. I am glad to see y'all, where y'all are today. I'm even more excited to see where God's going to take you guys in the future. I am glad that behind every great man is even a great woman. And for that, Shay, I salute you.
Over time, I realized, you know, she has a beautiful family. These children love her to death. They love me to death. And, like, I couldn't see anybody else more perfect for her. And how he roots for her is exactly what I want from my husband. Like, he wears shirts with her face. I'm like, you got her face on you. Like, what are you doing? And, you know, he's like, that's my baby, you know? And that like, just makes it so much better. And I love both of y'all.
Is this thing on? All right, y'all can hear me fine? All right. I wasn't expecting to be wired, so I have to watch what I say because they could use this as evidence. But anyway, thank you guys for coming out. I really appreciate it. Like, I really, really appreciate it. This is my second wedding to the same woman, a year apart. last year's wedding, like I said, well, it was really unexpected. We did not know we were going to get married. We didn't know we were moving. All of it came literally, move in on my birthday, get married a week later. So I've heard a lot of people say, well, you can just have a wedding down the line, but it never comes to pass. But we were able to make this happen. And me being her husband, I'm like, whatever it is that you want, I'm a hell or high water, I'm gonna make sure it happens. I traveled the globe from Jacksonville to Dallas to San Jose, San Jose back to Dallas, Dallas back to Jacksonville, North Carolina to just meet your family, your wonderful family that I'm glad to be a part of and feel accepted because I got a lot of babies. Things was in my head. Thank you, Isha. But I really appreciate it, and I feel the love. Thank you, I do. But special group of guys. Some of them had to leave were my groomsmen. I have my little big brother Renard. My little brother Dre. Older brother Ty. I don't call them my friends. They're my family. I don't have friends. I have family. You know, I got coworkers, and I got family. But each of these gentlemen, Artias had to leave. You know, my pops just spoke, and Tommy had to leave as well. But each of those guys played they were there, put it that way. They were hand selected. Each time I needed them, not one has failed when I needed them. And the big thing about it is they accepted my woman. And when I approached all of them saying, hey, I'm trying to shake this woman and I can't, and I'm literally trying to get rid of this woman, because the approach was, yeah, she saw the chocolate, she saw I was working out. You know, that's always a joke I told them, you know. I say, but she's really into me and I'm afraid of failure. I don't want to put my kids through that again. But their belief in my walk, you know, they backed it. They met and they're like, hey man, she the one. Each one that met her, yeah, she the one. I don't care what you say. We're not going to hear from you as much. Ain't no more playing ball, working out at the gym. We're not going to see you no more. So we're going to say our goodbyes now and we'll come back to you at your wedding. I just wanted everybody to know how much I really appreciate you guys and just standing in for me. I really appreciate it. I mean, I was in the trenches. Instead of pulling me out, you got down in there and fought with me. And I really appreciate that. And you made my wife smile. Thank you. And I'm not crying no more. Ever again. And I appreciate it. That's all I got to say. I thank you. Yeah.